us this evening. He's a little under the weather, so we wish him a speedy recovery. I'd like to ask that our pledge leader, Finley Payne, step forward now while I read a few remarks about Ms. Finley. This evening, our pledge leader is Finley Payne, a fifth grade honor roll student in Ms. Miller's class at Tabb Elementary. Finley has attended Tabb Elementary School since first grade. Her extracurricular involvement has included being a member of the Student Council, Tabb Tiger Course, Morning Show News Team, Art Club, and Forensics. Outside of school, Finley plays soccer and is a Girl Scout. Finley is a caring person who has raised money for the XOXO Pet Rescue by organizing lemonade stands. She likes to take care of the earth by participating in trash walks to clean up the environment. She is an excellent representative to lead us in the pledge this evening. Please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Finley. Okay, we're going to start out this evening with our recognitions and awards. And to begin the recognition section will be the seniors of the month. And we're going to go with Bruton High School, Ms. Haywood, first.
Thank you very much. I have the honor of introducing to you the senior of the month for October from Bruton High School, Rachel Brotherton. Rachel, if you will stand, she's here with parents, Peter and Don Brotherton. Everybody stand. Grandmother Betty Parker and Sister Paige. If you all will stand and stay standing as I share some information with you about Rachel. Rachel Brotherton is one of Bruton's finest students. Rachel is dedicated to her studies and helpful to fellow students. Since Rachel's freshman year, she has received numerous awards for her academic achievement in the areas of history and science. However, she really thrives in the area of mathematics and has been selected as the best math student each year. The College Board recently recognized Rachel as a National Merit semifinalist. Rachel seeks opportunities to help students as well as the community. At Bruton, she tutors students in math who only speak Spanish and also participates in food, toy, and clothing drives with the Key Club. Currently, Rachel is the vice chairman of the York County Youth Commission and promotes the voice of our youth in the county. She has also held leadership roles in several organizations, the Spanish Honor Society, Book Club, Mu Alpha Theta Club, Key Club, and International Thespian Society. While balancing her academics and service organizations, Rachel also competes in cross country, indoor track, and outdoor track, as well as varsity softball. Please join me in congratulating Rachel Brotherton as a senior of the month for Bruton High School.
Mr. Mathis, I believe you have our next award.
And Rachel, I may have a tutoring job for you in math. Get with you right afterwards. I have the honor of the senior of the month for Grafton High School. This is Julia Larson. Please stand up. And her parents, Wayne and Kathy. Anybody else with you? Any other siblings? No, that's it. For October, Grafton High School is proud to recognize Julia Larson as its senior of the month. Julia is a charismatic, caring, and committed student who has excelled in both academics and athletics during her years at Grafton. This year as a senior, Julia is the senior class president and the Model UN Secretary General. She is also a member of the National Honor Society, Mu Alpha Theta Math Honor Society, I may have a job for you also, and Spanish Honor Society. Julia's awards and honors are many, including Virginia's Girls State Representative for Grafton, AP Scholar with Distinction, and highest academic honors for each year at Grafton. As an athlete, Julia is a member of the track and field team, where she competes in the 1600, the 4x800, and the 1000 meter run. She has been a member of the varsity field hockey team for 2 years and the varsity soccer team for 4 years, with the last two as team captain. Last year, she earned first team all-conference in soccer and won the coveted Anchor Award, which is given to the most valuable player on the soccer team at Grafton. Julia's volunteer activities include serving as counselor for the 4-H summer camp and Catholic Heart Walk camp each year since the 10th grade. In all of this, she has also maintained a 4.67 GPA average to date and is pursuing several wonderful options for next fall, including the United States Air Force Academy, UVA, and Cornell. All great options there. Please join me in congratulating Gio Larson as Grafton's Senior October of the Month.
Our next Senior of the Month is from Tabb High School, Zach Wusk. And Mary Beth and Mike, Stan, I know this guy, he's a great kid. Zach Wusk is a Tabb Tiger through and through. He is an excellent contributor on the football field, having played all four of his high school years with two with JV and two with varsity. As a senior, he is the team captain. Zach is also an active member of the local lacrosse program and is team captain for lacrosse. He was named to the second team all-district and all-region this past spring. His final sport is bowling, which he has participated in since 2014 and is now the president of the club for his senior year. Academically, Zach is an excellent student as well. He is finishing the YCSD Honors Program in June 2017. His AP courses have included English language, U.S. history, calculus, and physics during his junior year. As a senior, he is taking AP English Literature, AP U.S. Government, AP Statistics, and Marine Biology. Through all of this, his overall GPA through the end of the junior year is 4.319. Outside of the classroom, Zach is an active member of Tabb's Student Ambassadors, and for his academic work, he has been inducted into both Mu Alpha Theta and the National Honor Society. In the community, Zach is a member of Young Life and volunteers regularly at his church as a reader and an acolyte, as well as for their homeless ministry. In short, Zach is a true example of a Tabb Tiger. Thank you, Zach. You make us proud. Congratulations. And Ms. Kirschke.
Yes, it is my honor to announce the Senior of the Month for October from York High School is Kyle Mastracci. Are you here, Kyle? Would you stand along with your parents, Patty and Mike? Anyone else with you? Intelligent, determined, patient, and respectful are adjectives that come to mind when asked to describe Kyle Mastracci. He is a stellar student, multi-talented athlete, superb leader, and role model for his classmates, and highly respected amongst the faculty and staff at York High. He is a dependable and reliable member of his community. Kyle's level of maturity and genuine compassion for others far outweighs that of his peers. He is a leader by nature. However, he does not lead by being loud, boisterous, or demanding. Kyle's leadership style is quite the opposite and far more effective. He leads by example, genuine, strong, and confident. As a result of his steadfast dedication to academics, Kyle has received a number of accolades, including highest academic honors and induction into the Spanish Honor Society, the National Honor Society, and Mu Alpha Theta, the Math Honor Society. He is a recipient of the 2016 AP Scholar Award and is also a participant in the School Division's Honors Program. Kyle's desire to excel is not only evident in the classroom, but in the athletic arena as well. He has earned numerous varsity letters in a variety of sports. However, swimming is Kyle's passion. He has lettered for 3 years and has been a Virginia High School League state meet qualifier for 2 years. And despite Kyle's busy schedule, he is actively involved in the youth ministry at his church and is a member of the Boy Scouts of America Order of the Arrow and the Sea Scouts. For all of these reasons and many more, we are very proud to have Kyle represent York High School. And we are very proud of you too, Kyle. Congratulations.
Okay, at this time, I'm going to have Dr. Shander go down front, and we're going to move into our Student Service Awards. We have two this evening, and the first one, I believe, Mr. Mathis, you have.
Yes. Student Service Award for October for Grafton Middle School is RN Prabhu Desi and Vice Principal Ebony Griffin. Could you please both come up? Grafton Middle School is proud to recognize RN Prabhu Desi as our Student Service Award winner. RN is the eighth grader who has made quite an impression on his first year principal before the school year even started. He spent no less than 20 hours at Grafton Middle School prior to the start of the year, reshelving books at the library, stuffing backpack school packets for open house, and helping set up the Clipper Camp. Outside of school, RN is an active young man trying to make an impact in his community. This year, he joined the Leaders Club at YMCA. The goal of the Leaders Club is to provide members with opportunities for leadership training, personal growth, and service to others. RN is also a member of the United States Tennis Association and swam for the Coast Guard Blue Dolphins for 3 years. In the classroom, he sets the standard for excellence. He is a straight-A student at Grafton Middle School. His teachers describe him as an awesome student and kid. He is eager to learn and a pleasure to teach. Please join me in congratulating RN Prabhu Desi for his recognition as the Grafton Middle School Student Service Award recipient.
I just want to know how he did on the pronunciation.
Was it okay?
Great. Our next Student Service Award is from Tab Elementary, Nicholas Turner. Nicholas, there you go. And Cheryl Parr. It is a pleasure to present the October Elementary School Student Service Award to Nicholas Turner, a fifth grade honor roll student in Mrs. Miller's class at Tab Elementary. Nicholas has been a Tab Tiger since kindergarten. When selecting a student for this award, it was easy to choose Nicholas because of the support he has provided to his fellow students throughout the time he has attended our school. Since 2011, Nicholas has raised well over $2,000 to directly support educational activities for Tab Elementary School through a PTA walkathon event. Each year, he has worked extremely hard to ensure this event is successful and our students are able to benefit from activities supported by these funds. His efforts are appreciated by us all. Nicholas also supports heart health by being a member of the Bouncing Tigers Jump Rope Demonstration Team, the only American Heart Association sponsored jump rope team in the state of Virginia. As a part of the team, he represents our school by traveling to other schools to encourage students to participate in heart healthy activities and to raise money for Jump Rope for the Heart, which supports the fight against heart disease. Nicholas is also a member of the Tab Tiger Course, Battle of the Books, Forensics, the Jump Rope Club, and previously was a member of the Morning Show News team. Outside of school, he is a member of the Royal Rangers at his church. Nicholas enjoys spending time with his family and watching TV whenever he can find a spare moment. Congratulations to Nicholas for his many achievements. Congratulations. Okay, at this time, we're going to move into our Community Volunteers of the Month, and Ms. Kirschke, you have our first volunteer.
I do. It is my honor to announce the Volunteer of the Month for Grafton Middle School is Martha Owens. Martha, would you please come to the stage along with Grafton Middle School Assistant Principal Ebony Griffin. Martha Owens is one of those rare volunteers who simply does everything and anything asked of her, and her dedication to Grafton Middle School students and her willingness to help out in any way has been an asset to the entire community. Martha has served on the PTSA Executive Board for 8 years, and she continued to serve on the Executive Committee during a gap year when she did not even have a student at Grafton Middle. Her work with the PTSA can be highlighted with her serving as the chair for the variety show for 8 straight years and co-chairing the 8th grade dance for 2 years. Martha has also supported the school as a career day speaker and has been a featured speaker at our Clipper Sippers. Martha also is an integral part of GMS Athletics. She has served as an athletic booster for 7 years and has been a supporting parent to the football and cheering teams. All GMS home football games begin with Martha singing the national anthem, and she may miss some of the action during the game because she is working the concessions. Grafton Middle School is grateful for the time that Martha Owens has given to the students and the community. Her commitment has benefited thousands of children and given them one of the best overall educational experiences. Martha, thank you so very much. You have given your time, your services, and your talents for years to not only Grafton Middle, but Coventry and Grafton High School as well as the entire York County School Division. And we thank you so very much. Congratulations.
And Mrs. Haywood.
I have the honor of introducing to you the Volunteer of the Month for October from Tabb Elementary School, Mandy Beeble. If she will come forward with Principal Cheryl Parr. Selecting Mandy Beeble for the October YCSD Elementary School Volunteer of the Month award was extremely easy. Mrs. Beeble has volunteered at Tabb Elementary since 2010. For the past 6 years, she has been a part of numerous volunteer opportunities to ensure our school is successful, not only for her own children, but for all of our students. During this time, she has directly supported individual classroom teachers and has also been an integral part of the success of our PTA. Mrs. Beeble has raised awareness of school events for our transient military population by serving as our main bulletin board coordinator. Early on, she recognized that providing information visually is a key to our success. For several years, she has also been our reflections coordinator, ensuring that the artistic efforts of our children are both recognized and celebrated. For the past couple of years, Mrs. Beeble has worked tirelessly as our PTA president as well, leading a core group of volunteers in many ways to support our school. Through her positive leadership, she continually shares her vision with other parents. She motivates those around her by serving as our school's number one cheerleader, which rallies everyone else into action. She truly believes that by providing quality assistance to our teachers and staff, our students directly benefit. Mrs. Beeble accomplishes all of this while raising 3 wonderful children and supporting a military spouse in his efforts to support our country safe, keep our country safe. Please join me in congratulating Mandy Beeble for her many contributions to Tabb Elementary School. Congratulations again.
At this time, Ms. Kersky, I'm going to turn it over to you to introduce the York Foundation for Public Education.
Yes, I would like to invite Kelly Ash, a board member to the York Foundation for Public Education, to come forward, along with Finley Payne, Nicholas Turner, Aran Prabhudesi, Rachel, Julia, Zachary, and Kyle. As they say on The Price is Right, come on down. We want to congratulate Finley Payne, a 5th grader from Tabb Elementary School, for reciting the Pledge of Allegiance at tonight's school board meeting. And we would like to recognize tonight's Student Service Award recipients: Nicholas Turner from Tabb Elementary School, R.M. Prabhudesi from Grafton Middle School, and our seniors of the month, Rachel Brotherton from Bruton High, Julia Larson from Grafton High, Zachary Wusk from Tab High, and Kyle Mastracci from York High. Special gifts from Cookie Text and Edible Tweet are being presented tonight on behalf of the York Foundation for Public Education and in partnership with Jeannie Fioka of Cookie Text and Edible Tweet. Let's give these remarkable students a round of applause. They are so deserving.
Dr. Shander, I believe you have the next item.
Thank you, Dr. George, board members. Each year, the VSBA recognizes board members for their dedication, time, and hard work in improving boardsmanship skills through VSBA meetings, conferences, board development, training, and active involvement in the association. VSBA members earn credits for VSBA Academy Awards, which are based on participation from July 1 to June 30th of each year. There are five levels of awards with certificates and pins awarded for particular levels. The VSBA Academy Awards are presented annually to school board members who meet the requirements. The awards being presented this evening are in each of our board member packets. The Award of Excellence and Silver Pin are presented this evening to Dr. George, Mr. Medford, and Ms. Haywood. Let's congratulate our board member. And the Award of Recognition is presented to Ms. Kirsty. Let's give her a congratulations. Board members, congratulations on your awards, and thank you for all you do to lead YCSD.
And Dr. Shander, at this time, if you look in your packet, you will find an Award of Excellence and a Silver Pin. And we thank you for all your efforts and all that you do, your leadership for us, New York County School Division. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, Dr. Shander, I believe you're going to introduce the next speaker.
Yes, for tonight's, for this evening's Accent on Academics, the project is Operation Grow Change, Growing Minds, Skills, Leadership, and Community. The York River Academy Greenhouse Project is an all-encompassing student-led laboratory. Students are creating and managing a business plan for a self-sustaining nonprofit organization. I'm going to ask Mr. Walt Cross, principal of York River Academy. He's going to now come forward and introduce the staff and student presenters. Mr. Cross.
Thank you. Dr. George, members of the board, Dr. Shander, and division staff and community members, we want to thank you for the opportunity to share a little bit about our greenhouse project. It's a project that we were able to fund through a supplemental grant that was provided by the Virginia Assembly for charter schools. So we're able to apply for that, as well as another grant from the Walmart Foundation. So everything you're going to see tonight has been supported by grants. So that's kind of a nice thing for all of us. We started with this project because a couple things. One is that it supports our charter goals and also our strategic goals here in the division to help enhance or produce productive citizens. People who can engage real work kind of activities, but in that safe environment of the school workshop. And this is what we're going to present to you tonight, the beginnings of this. There are so many people that have been involved in this, students and staff from York River Academy, family members, parents, community members, Greg Dolak and his staff. But the two people that we really want to focus on are the teachers who've really taken it on and are spearheading this. And this is Ms. Veronica Warwick, science teacher, and Jamie Norton, business ed teacher.
Good evening. My name is Veronica Warwick. I'm the science teacher facilitating this student-led greenhouse operation. The students involved in this directed study course actively participate in management, inquiry, experimentation, and investigation. The course goals are to provide the students with authentic learning experiences that have positive impacts on our community and environment.
Hello, I'm Jamie Norton. I facilitate the Directed Study Business course focusing on our greenhouse project, Operation Grow Change. We are focused on the entrepreneurial aspects of creating a self-sustaining nonprofit organization. Throughout the school year, we will investigate and apply business management and accounting principles. It is my pleasure to introduce our project leaders, Tim Tidwell, Austin Roop, Will Loafman, and Eric O'Neill.
So, good evening. I'm Tim Tidwell. As Dr. Shandor mentioned, our greenhouse project known as Operation Grow Change, we started over the summer and beginning or through the end of last year. We started out this year during the summer. As you can see in this video, we during the summer created our greenhouse structure involved with parents, students, staff, and then some community volunteers as well. It was an all-day process. It took a very long time on a not very nice day. But we decided to record the process of setting up the greenhouse. And through this video, you see our team working together to try and construct this throughout the day. We get both ends of the greenhouse up along with the side paneling. Later on, at the beginning of the school year, students assembled both the doors and windows to put onto the greenhouse. On this timeline, you'll see some of the major events that we've been able to accomplish throughout the school year, which we'll go into detail on these throughout the presentation. The first one that I'd like to talk about is going to be our blueprint that we created. This was our original blueprint we created the first week of school. It consisted of 6 tables and 2 raised beds that we wanted to put in, along with sink, and eventually power would be added. So we've gone a little bit further in this blueprint and decided to take those 2 raised beds out in place of adding 2 extra tables. We decided that it would be, one, more effective for growing the plants, as well as give us more space to access those plants. So I'll step back.
Okay, so one of the accomplishments of our class is that we completed a shed in approximately 1 week, and it is used for storing our major tools that we use for maintenance in the shed, as well as other items. The first field trip that we went on was the Ken Matthews Garden Center field trip, and that was on September 20th. And the major things that we learned there was more of plant care and how to take care of them better. So the second field trip we took was the Anderson Showplace field trip. That was on September 26th, and there we learned more of the greenhouse management, how to take care of them, how to climate manage them, as well as more plant things such as pruning them. So this is the time lapse of our plants, and the large plants that are growing that you can see are the tomato plants. Behind them is the basil, which you can see on your table right there. And then behind that is parsley and chamomile. And right now, the tomatoes are the largest plants we have.
So eventually, when the plants have matured enough, we transplant them into bigger pots. In these photos, you can see some of our team members working on transplanting the basil to some of the larger pots. It allows the plants more rooms to grow, and this is done once every week. So some of our ongoing activities include plant care, which is when we water and inspect our plants daily and to make sure they're doing all right. Future planning, which we'll plan to do in the future for the plants. Inventory management, where we strive to maintain an accurate record of our inventory, what we have, and plant evaluation, which is where we estimate the value of what our plants will be worth. So yeah, here we have some of the current production that we have. And in the top picture is actually tomatoes, which are doing the best. And we have the rest of the herbs at the bottom picture right there. And we're planning on growing more vegetables and fruits and flowers along the way.
As you can see, here is our inventory management. In the product inventory section is everything we currently own and we have in the shed as well as in the classrooms. And the purchase list history on the right shows everything we've bought in the green, everything in the yellow is what we currently have in order, and if there was anything in the red, was something we would need. Now the plant research and valuation, the top part is a snip of research we took. It contains information of ideal plant care as well as time to maturity of most of the plants, well, all of the plants, sorry. The bottom part is the plant valuation. It calculates the average cost of the seeds for the plants as well as how much we could sell them for. And the goods and services we are striving to provide are the K through 5 field trip that we're organizing to involve K through 5 students, and we're targeting certain SOL objectives. And we also have homemade soaps, organic vegetables and herbs, fresh bouquets and potpourri for houses, and yeah, smell nice. So are there any questions?
So are you selling your products?
Yeah, we plan on selling some of the plants, well, all the plants and flowers and bouquets.
Yeah. Awesome.
Where at?
Well, we're currently trying to decide who our target market is, mostly just the public.
Will we get invitations?
We have a grand opening with a sale or something.
That'd be nice.
Not to put you on the spot, what's the most interesting thing you've learned or something unexpected that you didn't think that you would garner from this experience?
Well, in the process of doing this, I learned that you can take pieces of a plant and just cut them off and put them in the dirt or put them in water and let the roots grow out, and that's called plant propagation, and it'll grow an entirely new plant right out of that, so I thought that was really interesting.
You started with the herbs, and then you have a list of things that you will be producing also, the carrots, the so forth and so on. Do you foresee the size of your greenhouse expanding?
Well, we do have a raised bed that we are working on outside of the greenhouse. So, yes, we definitely do see our greenhouse expanding.
Great. Well done.
Yeah. It's a great project.
It was excellent. Excellent. Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Yes.
This time the board's going to take a short recess so we can come down and introduce ourselves to our award recipients this evening. Okay, welcome back to the York County School Board meeting. This evening we're going to go to our unfinished business, and I see that we have none. So we'll go straight into presentations. Dr. Shander, would you like to introduce our first?
Yes, thank you, Dr. George. Board members, I'm going to ask Dr. Carl James, Chief Operations Officer, if he'll please come. This month's construction report, easy for me to say. Dr. James.
Thank you, Dr. Shander. And Mr. Shearhart's absent. He took a well-deserved vacation, and he gave me some feedback on tonight's presentation, so I need to make sure I stand up and meet his standards for this evening, because he said he's going to be watching when he gets home to make sure I did this correctly. Anyway, tonight I'll focus on three projects, and the first is going to be the Waller Mill Elementary School additions and renovations. This project, as you know, was divided into two phases. The first phase, as you can see on the floor plan, are the areas in blue and white. And currently, the section in green is where the contractor is working now to complete the renovation portion of this project. Students and teachers are working in the blue and green portions here. First phase, I can tell you, is almost done. The parking lot lights have been installed. The landscaping around the front is completed. This weekend, they installed the cafeteria sound attenuation panels. And the contractor has started preparations for the installation of the playgrounds. As you know, they were removed during the construction of the additional classrooms, and now he's in the process of putting them back into place. And the contractors, the subcontractors, are working on a myriad of punch list items that should be completed soon. Now, the final phase, I can tell you, is going well. The HVAC units and the ductwork are installed. The piping for the HVAC units has also been installed, and the piping has also been insulated. This week, the contractor should install the ceiling grid in the classrooms, as well as the lights in the classrooms. The casework for those classrooms will ship today, so within the next couple of weeks, all that will be installed. And completion of this phase of the project is at the end of December. You can see here, looking at the front of the building, you can see it's been landscaped now. You see some shrubbery there that's been planted recently. It really looks nice up there. Secondly, the LED lights that are in the parking lot. These are very energy efficient, and that's entering the bus loop at night. You can see how bright it is, how well lit it is there with the new kind of lights. I can tell you that all of the lights that have been replaced in this building are LED, and they are very energy efficient. Here's a view of the front of the school at night with all the lights on. And that's all I have for Walden Mill Elementary. The next project is going to be the Grantham School Complex partial replacement and coating. The contract at this point has removed all of the components of the roof that were scheduled for replacement. All of the drain lines have been installed and insulated. An emphasis now is placed on the installation of new gutters and downspouts, as well as starting the coating of the entire roof. The substantial completion of this project is November the 30th, and the final completion is December the 30th. Hopefully we can get this in before the temperature at night drops below 40 degrees. We need that to make sure that coating will have time to cure.
And hopefully have a wonderful new year.
Yes, ma'am. We very much hope. Here's a picture of the top of the school. That's, as you can tell just by looking at, that's around the auditorium looking from the middle school side. You can see there where they have removed a section of the roof and put it back in place. You see some of the insulation panels that's been installed. And you can see a worker, part of the group there, working all the way down there at the far end, before you get to the high school side, putting on the additional insulation. Once this part is complete, then they put on the gutters, and then they start the entire coating of the roof. The final project I'm going to talk about this evening is the Bailey Field Track Resurfacing Project. As you can see here, here's a picture of the track. This is with one coat of rubber installed. The contractor had hoped to finish the next three coats this past weekend, but because of the weather and the winds yesterday, he could not do it, so he was working today. And it's anticipated that he'll finish all of the coating of the track with the rubber tomorrow, and then he will return in 2 weeks to give this time to cure before he puts the lines on this particular track. So that's your capital construction project report for this evening. Are there any questions?
Updates on one Watermill and the other, the Grafton School Complex. You mentioned the cafeteria, putting the sound panels up and everything.
Yes.
What's the status of the kitchen?
Oh, they started in the kitchen last week.
Last week. So,
yes, sir.
No longer getting food from Bruton.
School is no longer being transported from Bruton. They're able to prepare.
And so they'd finished covering. Decided they need to do for the food.
Yes, sir. And it passed final inspection, so now they can now work and serve food in the cafeteria.
Great. And as far as the roof goes at the Grafton School Complex, just for my information and those who are listening, if you're aware, have all the drains been moved and replaced and connected?
Yes. What Mr. Mathis is talking about it, they had to rework the drains. They put in new drains and moved some of the other drains with the design of the roof architect to allow for greater drainage. And the drainage is very important because the water ponds on that roof. Of course, it carries unnecessary weight, but then it's not going to run off. And eventually, if it gets too high, and that's one of the problems we encountered, we found the water was getting beyond the flashing that comes up by the parapet walls, and that was leaking. Yeah. And this particular installation with the new drains in place and creating an 8-inch tall flashing versus 4 inches it was originally, that should help with any ponding or the amount of water that's on the roof.
Yeah. Thank you. Good news.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. James.
Okay, that's all we have under presentations this evening. Next, we're going to move into our time of comments of citizens. This evening, we have two opportunities to speak. One is a public participation. The second is a public forum on goals and objectives for the FY18 capital improvements program and the operating budget. And that is an opportunity to provide input on which items the public would like to see in the CIP and the operating budget. So there were two sign-up sheets, one just for general public participation, one for the public forum. The rules apply for both. Please state your name and address. You have 3 minutes. Please keep your comments directed strictly to the school board. But we're going to start this evening first with the public participation. If you did not sign up to speak, you will have an opportunity at the end of the meeting to do so. First up is Sam Urey.
Sam Urey, 302 Penrith Crossing, Yorktown, Virginia, 23692. Dr. Shandor, Dr. George, other members of the York County School Board. As president of the York Education Association, we're very pleased with the consistency of your proclamations for American Education Week. We thank you for your recognition of your staff. As an association committed to public education and the students we serve, the York Education Association sincerely hopes you will also pass a resolution in support of the implementation of the Every Student Succeeds Act, known as ESSA. The local associations are working in cooperation, our local associations working in cooperation with those in Newport News, Gloucester, Hampton, Pocosin, and Williamsburg, James City County, and are making inroads as well with the Student Education Association affiliates that we have. The ESSA Community Forum will be on November 14th, and we would like all of you to mark your calendars and hopefully be there. Those efforts require an all-hands-on-deck approach as we establish the unique requirements needed to be developed to determine what success in our schools will look like. These efforts are coupled with the efforts of the state of Virginia to establish what our future graduates will look like, what our schools will look like to produce those particular graduates. Combine that with the re-benchmarking of the standards of quality to properly reflect the practices of the locals in our state. To put it in terms you can easily understand, this is like a super alignment of all the constellations, the perfect storm for educational, for advancement of education in the state of Virginia, as well as the nation. Now, locally, we have some serious work to do. Not all our members of our educational community are being heard. As such, I feel it is imperative to speak for them. They need to be heard. You will start to see more and more shirts like this one, to show our support of the association's drive to make this year the year of the ESP, or the Education Support Personnel. I have shirts for each of one of you to show your support. Thank you for your, thank you and every member of the board and every member of the superintendent's staff, and we hope that you will double down on your commitment to do all we can for them. You can't spell respect without ESP. You cannot teach our kids unless bus drivers bring them to school, secretaries and clerks keep records, teachers, assistants, call paraeducators now, help us to teach, nurses help them to feel better, cafeteria staff feeds them, computer techs make computers work, library techs and library clerks help them to find their books, custodians keep the school clean, and maintenance staff keeps it all running. Thank you for your support of all these people. We greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for the shirts.
Thank you very much.
Kathleen Howe.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Kathleen Howe, and I reside at 121 Lance Way, Yorktown, Virginia, 23693. I wanted to thank the board for the progress made thus far with the RFP 1983 medical assets. I look forward to future updates on that RFP as well. The Survey Monkey that you sent out in October, I thought was fantastic to get the got a lot of feedback, and I look forward to those responses as well. I want to thank you all for caring for not only our children's academics, but also their safety in getting to and from school. by you sending out that Survey Monkey, that is going to start the brain process for a lot of parents to think, what are we doing? How can we better serve our youth? And I look forward to hopefully seeing a school start time of 8 a.m. or later for all of the students within your county be implemented sometime within the next 2 years. But thank you again for all your hard work and dedication. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, the only people I have signed up for the public participation, the next is the public forum, and I'd like to open the public forum on goals and objectives for FY18 Capital Improvements Program and Operating Budget. We have one person signed up, David Forrest.
Hello, I'm David Forrest. I live at 104 Three Point Court in Yorktown. What I'm here to say is that York County elementary schools are overcrowded and do not meet the state standards. The planning we've done since 2009 has produced the situation that we're in, so we need to ask for more now and in the future. On May 9th, Dr. James presented the current and planned levels of overcrowding at York elementary schools. Overall, we're at 97% capacity and projected to go to 101% capacity without including the new school. The ideal target crowding level is 85 to 90%. A 500-seat school on a site size for 470 students is not going to fill the 1,100 hole in the capacity that drops out from trying to apply that target level to the projected level of stuff. The enrollment of 97% of total elementary capacity that we're currently at makes it impossible to do any rezoning to actually solve the overcrowding and to bring all of the schools that are rezoned into that ideal 85 to 90% range. So schools like Yorktown Elementary are end up running at 115% capacity. Right now, Yorktown Elementary is a substandard parking, substandard hard surface playgrounds, and a substandard usable lot size. The undersized site makes it so the temporary buildings end up using up the state-mandated hard surface playgrounds and also require permanent zoning variance to push the Head Start trailer over the building lines. Yorktown Elementary can't manage its own problems internally when saddled with the current 115% capacity, let alone with the projected overcrowding projected to be 137%. Now, the 20 schools that we have, it each at about $25 million, end up adding up to about $500 million worth of school infrastructure that you have. If you have that on like a 40-year depreciation thing, you end up needing to maintain about half a school worth or $12.5 million worth of infrastructure just to keep steady in things. And you know, you're not getting that much from the county. From what I understand, the county has directed York County School District to ask for less by pushing the maintenance off for another 2 years, lowballing the delayed maintenance by ignoring the cost of inflation and delayed maintenance, and shortening the CIP plan to 6 years to push things off the end of the planning window. In 2009, 7 years ago, York County School District started planning the new school to cover the expected development, and that lead time wasn't nearly enough to offset the overcrowding that we are experiencing now. In light of past performance, can we honestly say that the six-year plan with the 500 to 700-seat school in the, that we've delivered to the Board of Supervisors is going to bring Yorktown Elementary or the York Elementary School system up to state standards? The Board of Supervisors has given you everything you've asked for, but you should certainly be planning and asking for enough to cover the development planned on the books, the schools, up to the state standards. You should also make it clear how shortchanging the plan will continue to produce substandard schools.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Those are the only speakers we have signed up. Once again, I will give an opportunity at the end of the meeting if anybody else would like to speak. With that, I'm going to close the public forum. At this time, we're going to move into matters by board members. And I think I'll start down on the end down there with Todd.
A few of the highlights this last month since our last formal meeting was visited Mount Vernon, had a great hour and a half conversation and with the principal and tour of the building, and watching some great instruction going on at the time, and showed me how they're using the additional wing that they put in about 5 years ago. And speaking of capital improvements, she was showing me the walkway covering that they would like to keep the kids out of the elements and for security and safety reasons. And fully has my support for that getting funded in the CIP, and it is a very high priority for the principal at the school there. But it was a very good meeting we had, and it was a great tour. That's it's a great school down there and a great little neighborhood. Now on to get to concentrate a little bit on the bands. A few congratulations are in order here, especially for York High School, the Falcon Band, as they competed in the Monarch Invitational Marching Band Competition on the Ides of October, that's the 15th, at Todd Stadium, and placed first in the AA division. And a big congrats also to Grafton High School Band as they placed first in the 5A division. Furthermore, we wish the Falcon Band lots of luck as they compete at the Bands of America Atlanta Super Regional Marching Band Championship this weekend coming up in Atlanta, Georgia. So great job by them, and good luck into the future. Also tomorrow, there's the Band Expo down at Bailey Field. It's free of charge. It starts at 7:30. All four of our high schools with bands are going to be there. It starts at 7:30, and they're all going to be tearing up the field, showing some great performances, not tearing it up literally, just lighting up the field on some great marching band stuff, and I highly encourage everybody to come out there for that. That's all I have.
Thank you.
And it is free of charge. I don't know if I mentioned that or not. So.
Okay. I had the opportunity to slip into a couple of meetings this past month. One, the Special Education Advisory Committee, and the second, the Gifted Education Advisory Committee. And I was so very pleased to see the large number of parents who participate and take an active role on these committees. It was very encouraging to see. You always think about the PTA and the parents who volunteer in the schools, but we have a strong advocacy for two very important groups, special education and gifted, and they are representing all the schools in York County, and it was really, there were two very good meetings. It was so wonderful to see them take an active role. I want to thank them for their involvement. I also want to thank the staff because the meetings are held at night so parents can attend the meetings and after their normal work day. But our staff, they were there till late, and I just want to acknowledge that they're not working just 9-to-5 jobs. They're here at school board meetings. They're here at committee meetings. And so I want to thank you. I also want to say mark your calendars because the York Foundation for Public Education will hold its 5th annual Restaurant Week, November 6th through the 12th. The restaurants are not all listed on the website, but they will be soon. And if you would like to find out more information, just check out the York Foundation link on yorkcountyschools.org. If you have a restaurant and you would like to participate, you can contact Belinda Willis. Part of the sales will go to fund grants and scholarships for our students and our staff. And speaking of staff, we have a very special employee at the school board office. She is the face of for people who enter the building, and she is the voice if you telephone. And I would just like to give a huge shout out of appreciation to Mary Jo Padula. I think she watches our meetings regularly. Let's give her a round of applause. She is a wonderful person, a wonderful employee, and she represents the school board office extremely well. Mm-hmm. And finally, I would like to congratulate the Grafton High School field hockey team.
Ms. Haywood?
Let her do it.
I would like to congratulate the Grafton High School field hockey team for being the new Bay Rivers District champions.
after a wonderful win against TAB in two overtimes, and it was a 3-2 score. And yes, I am partial. I will admit my daughter plays on that team and has for 4 years. So, but this is an outstanding group of girls, and I just want to give them a huge congratulations.
And what the proud mother didn't say, her daughter scored.
Hey.
Congratulations.
I also want to echo what Mr. Mathis said about the marching band expo tomorrow night. That should be a fantastic evening at Bailey Field. One of the other activities that has already occurred has been Yorktown Day. And for years, the participation of the schools in the Bruton District has not been a part of that just because of the logistics and because of location. But this year, it was wonderful to have Bruton High and Queens Lake participate. And the pictures I've seen has been of Bruton High in the parade. So it's been wonderful to say we're all part of this county and how we pull together for that. And at Magruder Elementary School, they had their voting already, but their voting, which they participated in, was for Bullying Prevention Month. And they were voting on themes for Spirit Week. So they went through the whole process of setting up an election. And that was fantastic for them to participate in. And again, good luck to everybody as we continue to move through the school year and working hard and as we move into budget session. Thank you.
Nice. Thank you. Okay, just a couple of brief remarks. One is I wanted to give some recognition to a unique event that's getting ready to happen called the First Annual Principal for a Day event. Mm-hmm. This is an event where elected officials from the Board of Supervisors, the school board, legislators at the local level, at the state level, business partners, and local military leaders have an opportunity to spend a day with the principal at a school. And basically, it's designed to help these leaders learn how rewarding and demanding it is to be an educator and also to gain a better understanding of one of York County's strongest assets, which is certainly our public education system. So sounds like a really neat opportunity, and I think all of us are going to participate in some way. I'm just not sure which school yet, but looking forward to it. So I guess I'll get my comfortable shoes on and be prepared to
a good rock and roll
however many hours at the school. Halloween, something a little lighter. Be careful, please. You've got little goblins everywhere, so please drive safely, as always. We are going to have an opportunity next month, the board, to go to the Virginia School Board Association meeting in Williamsburg, and we look forward to that every year. They have some really great continuing education, and so we're looking for an opportunity to participate in that. And with that, that's about all I have. Unless anybody else has anything? All righty. Well, we're going to move right into financial matters, and I believe, Ms. Haywood, you are going to share that.
I still have financial matters, beginning with consideration of approval of claims certified for payment from September the 1st to September the 30th in the amount of $4,078,663.59. There are some items on page one I would like to highlight. There are three Power School group payments. Those three total $97,290. This is for the assessment bank for math and English for grades through 12. We had this a few months ago under procurement. If you move somewhat to the middle of the page, you have Dell Marketing LP down through SMS Tech Solutions, and I've grouped those together. This is purchased through the DOD, DODIA grant for the schools identified there. This purchase has now been completed, and this is paying the bill, and that's totaling $114,240.64. The other item on this page that I would like to just say I've noticed that been such a positive piece is the uniform centers for the custodial uniforms. There was a time that you would go into our schools and you knew that the custodians were there. You knew them. But now each school, they wear uniforms. And I think that's just such a heartwarming part of school spirit to see the uniforms. I move to the second page there, page 3. Comfort System USA, that's the replacement of chillers for Tab Middle School in the amount of $148,375. Moving slightly down, Tyler Technologies. This is the hardware. There's a new software package for transportation. EduLog no longer can supply our needs for this technology. So Tyler Technologies will be utilizing them. This is starting the planning phase, and we will start the end of this fiscal year and move into early next fiscal year to get this in place. Abacus Sports, this is Magruder Elementary gym floor replacement. This is polyurethane and vinyl. It's a long-lasting floor, and it's a multi-purpose floor, which will suit Magruder Elementary very well. Verco Incorporated, the wall and mill additions and renovations. This is the furniture for the 10 new classrooms in the amount of $61,000. Moving down to the track at York High, Dr. James shared with you the resurfacing at Bailey Field. We're looking at two XL payments to XL, one for York High and then third from the bottom to Bruton High to resurface the track fields. Even though you had it in your construction report, the roof service corporation to the Grafton High, Grafton Middle partial roof replacement in the amount of $185,456. Just wanted to mention that we're still working on that roof. Prevail Contracting, two paint jobs there. Keep in mind that Grafton Complex has not been painted since it was built. So oftentimes when you do paint, you feel a whole lot better of the of your location. The last two things I want to mention only for safety and security reasons. You have two amounts, $15,136 and $15,375 to Access Global. This is the security camera and alarm systems at York Elementary and at Magruder Elementary for the temporary trailers. If I may move now to the monthly financial report, the first for operating budget. If you compared received to date under the federal line item of $1,051,730, and you look at where we were last year this time, $6,676,715. Remember last year we had a one-time payment of impact aid. We will not get that this year, so that shares with you why there is a difference at this point in time. We're at 52% of our revenue. And if you look down, and we're only at 18% of our expenditures. There are three bullets at the bottom of that page I just want to draw your attention to. Again, the large impact payments that were received by this time in FY16. The increase in transportation is because bus driver salaries includes an extra pay period in September. And there are more drivers and more routes. Also, there's an encumbrance for bus replacement this year. And lastly, an increase in the FY17 is due to purchased services, telephone charges, materials, and supplies. And if you will now move to the monthly financial for food service. If you look at received to date under local sources, that's 2,400,469 compared to last year at this time of the 230,449. This could be misleading a little bit because last year we received a $27,000 grant from Sodexo. We don't have that this year. So that's why there is a very big discrepancy across from last year to this year this time. We're at 5% revenue. We're at 48% expenditures, and this is still early in the year. We will continue to monitor this since we are a self-supporting program. Also keep in mind that this report also includes a very successful breakfast program and an increase in the breakfast program across the schools. It also reflects that 10-cent increase in lunch prices in the received to date area, and it's also a reflection of the federal USDA dollars that we receive. And lastly, if I may look at procurement, and procurement is expenditure of $50,000 or more, and we only have one item, and that's the Bruton High School track renovations. It's estimated to be at $94,809. And with that, I move financial report.
Could I have a second?
Second.
Any questions? Ms. Ford.
A motion is made by Mrs. Haywood and seconded by Mrs. Kroschke to approve financial matters. Mr. Mathis?
Yes.
Mrs. Haywood?
Yes.
Mrs. Kroschke?
Yes.
Dr. George?
Yes. Next, we have our consent calendar. We have seven items. I'm just going to briefly read them. Approval of personnel actions, approval of donations in the amount of $2,683.60. Scared me for a moment there. Approval of the 2016-17 Gifted Education Advisory Committee. Approval of the overnight field trips and student activities for the period of November 1st through October 31st. Approval of minutes from a regular meeting on September 26th and a work session on October 10th, all 2016. Approval of a motion to authorize superintendent to execute amendment between number 7 to the food service management contract between the County Board of School Board of York County, Virginia, and Sodexo Operations. And finally, approval of a motion to authorize the superintendent to execute a memorandum of understanding for the Family Preservation School Support Program by and between York Pocosin Department of Social Services and the County School Board of York County, Virginia. I'd like to make a motion to approve the consent calendar. Could I have a second?
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Ford.
A motion is made by Dr. George and seconded by Mr. Mathis to approve the consent calendar. Mrs. Haywood?
Yes.
Mr. Mathis?
Yes.
Mrs. Kroschke?
Action items. We have three listed. First is approval of a proclamation for American Education Week. Dr. Shander?
Thank you, Dr. George. American Education Week is held every November to spotlight the importance of providing every child in America with a quality public education. York County schools, along with school divisions across the country, provide young people with the skills and knowledge needed to make productive contributions to the world. From our team of more than 1,800 employees to our parents, community members, and business owners, we all have a stake in public education, and we all have a role to play in supporting our students. Therefore, the school board is asked to join the state and the federal government in proclaiming that November 14th through the 18th be celebrated as American Education Week in all York County schools.
Thank you, Dr. Shander. I need a motion to approve the proclamation for American Education Week.
I move approval.
Could I second.
Thank you, Mrs. Ford.
A motion is made by Mrs. Kroschke and seconded by Mrs. Haywood to approve the proclamation. Mrs. Haywood?
Yes.
Mr. Mathis?
Yes.
Mrs. Kroschke?
Yes.
And Dr. George?
Yes. Next, we have approval of minutes from a regular meeting on August 22nd, 2016.
Move approval.
Second.
Thank you. Any questions?
And seconded by Mrs. Kroschke to approve the minutes from August 22nd. Mrs. Haywood?
Yes.
Mr. Mathis?
Abstain.
Mrs. Kroschke?
Yes.
And Dr. George?
Yes. And finally, we have approval of minutes from a special meeting on October 10th. But because Mr. Medford is not here this evening, we'll wait and vote on this item at our November meeting so that our quorum can be met. We had several members who were not in attendance at that meeting.
And next, we're going to move into policy. We have one item under discussion, and Dr. Shandor, I'm going to ask you to lead off on that.
Thank you. I'm going to ask Dr. Guy if she'll please come to the microphone. Related to the annual review of file IGBC, Family Involvement Policy of the York County School Board Policy Manual. Dr. Guy?
Thank you. Federal regulations require school divisions to review and update the Title I Family Involvement Policy annually. On June 3, 2016, a division-wide Title I Parent Advisory Council met and reviewed file IGBC, Family Involvement. The Parent Advisory Council made one recommended change. Specifically, they recommended the addition of one sentence. If an additional open house is needed, it should occur by February. And that was specifically for Bethel Manor and their military population. File IGBC will come back to the board in November for a first reading. Do you have any questions?
I don't believe so.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Guy.
Thank you. Okay, we have nothing under first reading, nothing under second reading, and it brings us to our report of the superintendent, Dr. Shandor.
Thank you, Dr. George. Just a couple highlights that I'd like to share from some recent events. In celebration of School Bus Transportation Employee Appreciation Day, several members of our executive leadership team, many of them who are here this evening, visited various locations in the division last Monday morning with hot coffee and donuts in recognition of the great work of our transportation staff members and what they do each day for our students and staff. Many of our schools also celebrated. If you're on Twitter, you can see many of our students holding signs up, singing, playing musical instruments, celebrating our transportation folks. And we certainly appreciate all of their efforts every day. Next, also, I had the opportunity last week to speak to a leadership class at York High School. They invited me to lead a discussion with the students. I came away so impressed and thoroughly enjoyed the experience. That's something I wish I can do every day. And the good news is we're all in good hands. There's some good future leaders out there, so we're in great hands. Next, I also had the opportunity last week to, along with several other area superintendents from Mecosin, Newport News, Hampton, and Isle of Wight, to share information related to the accomplishments of all of our school divisions with the Association of Realtors at their general membership meeting. We spoke to approximately 50 realtors, and it was excellent discussion regarding all of the schools in our region. Finally, I did want to sort of follow up on one of the items that Ms. Kersky brought up related to both the special and the Gifted Education Advisory Council. We're really proud of all the work that we do working with our parents. Dr. Vladu, Ms. Skinner, Dr. Guy, and many others who and all of our staff members, Dr. Gould and many of our special ed folks who work with those organizations. There's a lot of great work going on in those advisory councils. The one thing I wanted to share this evening is in the past 2 or 3 years, we've had 5 or 6 parents show up for SEAC. Last week, or 2 weeks ago, whenever that meeting was, we had 26 parents show up. So that's an incredible increase. That's our goal, is to increase those relationships as much as possible. I was talking to some of the special ed staff this morning. They were thrilled with that level of parental involvement. Some of our parents have some wonderful ideas moving forward, so we're looking forward to that work. Finally, a few weeks ago, many of our team members participated in the Meet the Administrators event, along with many of our staff members, to kick off the York County Council of PTA's first meeting of the school year. Our team really enjoyed that discussion, as well as answering several questions from that group. We appreciate our parent leaders and thank them for all they do to support the schools. With that, this concludes the superintendent's report.
Thank you, Dr. Shandor. I'll ask at this time if there's anybody else that wishes to address the board that did not have an opportunity to do so. Mrs. Howe? You already addressed the board.
I did once, but it's real quick. I was Kathleen Howe. I live at 121 Lance Way, same place I lived a few minutes ago. I just wanted to say, in the future, can we post the budget on the screen? Because for us who are sitting here to try to visualize the numbers on the paper, we can't write as fast as you guys are rattling the numbers off. In some cases, it just makes it easier for us to see the numbers.
We'll definitely make a note of that. Thank you.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Thank you. Okay, our next work session will be on November 7th at 6 o'clock downstairs. And We do have a need for a closed session, so if I could have a motion and a second to take the board into closed session, I would appreciate it.
I move that the York County School Board convene in closed session pursuant to the Virginia Freedom of Information Act for the following purposes. One, to consult with legal counsel under Virginia Code 2-23711A7, in particular, actual or probable litigation involving the school division.
Second.
Mrs. Ford?
A motion is made by Mrs. Haywood and seconded by Mrs. Kirschke for the school board to enter into closed session. Mr. Mathis?
Yes.
Mrs. Kirschke?
Yes.
Mrs. Haywood?
Yes.
And Dr. George?
Yes. Thank you. Good night. Meeting adjourned.